Pam says, how do you tell your guy what you want and need without sounding needy? Well, there's a whole bunch of different ways to do that, actually. One is to have a real conversation about it. Have you ever heard of the love languages? Basically, one of the conversations that you can have is a conversation. So one of the things that you want to do is do the love languages thing and find out what your love language is, find out what his love language is, all that kind of stuff. It's a great book, Five Love Languages. Don't remember the guy's name at the moment, but it's a great book. Next thing you want to do is you want to find out exactly what makes him feel loved, right? What makes him feel like, you know, he is feeling loved or what he appreciates, what he likes. And you can just ask him that. And usually guys might be like, oh, you know, and if he's like, oh, I'm not really sure, what you can do is you can tell him, you can go first and just talk about what it is that makes you feel loved. And then you will be telling him and you'll let him know. Right. And, but you can't rely on that. You can't rely on that. Unfortunately, you can't, right? Because guys, what happens when you tell them things that are important? They go in one ear and out the other, right? This is what happens with a lot of guys because they're, you know, I don't know why. It's just something that happens. I'm really bad with birthdays. So if you have a birthday coming up, you got to put it in my calendar if you want me to remember it. I'm sorry. Sorry. It's just really difficult. I've been trying to remember my brother's birthday for years. Every year I call him like 2 days afterwards and I'm like, hey bro, was it your birthday already? He's just like, dude, I hate you right now. You know, just like, ah, dude, I love you, man. I love you. So we have that strong bro love going on. But so what you want to do, the next thing that you want to do, sorry, I was getting off track there. The next thing that you want to do is you want to start framing it. And I talk all about this in my Love Frames Toolkit if you're interested in that. And basically what you do is you start talking about what it is that you like in terms of it being attractive or unattractive, right? So if there's something that you like him doing and he does it, then you want to give him a positive association, right? So we associate with different things, right? It's called neurological emotional anchoring. And what you want to do is you want to anchor in to his mind things that you think that you want him to do as attractive and making him feel more attractive, because everybody wants to feel attractive. I want to feel attractive. You know, I worked really hard on my hair before I did this video here, right? See my hair? It's great, right? This is long, hard work on this hair right here. So we all want to feel attractive. And if you want him, and so what you want to do is you just want to, if he does something that you like, you say that you find it attractive, right? You think it's hot, like, oh, it was so hot when you did that. It was so attractive when you did that. It was so sexy when you did that, right? Or what you can do is you can just talk about it in terms of different things that you like, you know, like, you know, I love it when you know, you do this. I love it when you do that. I think it's, you know, it's just, you know, that other day when you did that one thing, like that was so hot. Like it just, I don't know. It just turned me on so much when you're doing that. It was such a man thing. It was so cool, you know? And basically what you're doing is you're teaching him what it is that you want him to do. And so you just do that over and over and over again for different things. And eventually he'll start associating it, right? Because he'll be like, oh, she thinks that's hot. You know, she's getting turned on. Oh, I love that, right? And I want her to be more turned on more often. And so he will start getting excited, right? That hits his emotions when you tell him that. You're like, oh, that was hot. And he's like, whoa, she thinks that was hot, right? And so next thing you know, he's thinking about it in that way. And so you just do that over and over and over again. Or you can have that conversation where you talk about those things. There are other ways to do it as well. I talk about it in some of my programs,